might destroy some clues?
You don't find proof sitting behind a desk. We're not in the habit of trampling things into the ground, even if we're not in the FBI.
No. No, of course not. That's not what I meant.
Tony, I don't want to see a single shit-stirring journalist within a mile of here. You got it?
Yes, Lieutenant.
Listen, you look busy. Do you mind if I have a look around?
Be my guest.
Hey, Jaden, you come and see me if you find anything, okay? We're on the same team now.
Pretty chilly, huh?
Is that a coffee you drink in there?
There's some in the thermos behind you. Help yourself.
When do they find the body?
Excuse me, but who are you exactly?
Norman Jaden, FBI.
If you want to ask questions, you should speak to Lieutenant Blake, sir.
Lousy weather, huh? Does it always rain like this?
It rains every fall. Doesn't it do that where you come from?
Well, yeah. Yeah, of course.
Harry, comment. The victim is lying on his back. No visible signs of violence. His face is covered with mud, like the other victims. Superficial wound on the right thigh. Blood analysis suggests it could be post-mortem. Probably a scratch that occurred when the body was being moved.
Small wound on the right thigh. And the blood is the same as on the tracks. A small origami figure in the right hand. An orchid was placed on the victim's chest. The victim is Jeremy Bowles, declared missing 5 days ago. See reference file.
carried comment, sample of no interest, comes from one of the policemen present on the wasteland.
I'm heading back to the office. You staying?
No, I've seen enough. I'm leaving too.
Harry, comment, sample of no interest. Comes to one of the policemen present on the wasteland.
Don't think, Ethan. Give me the first idea that pops into your head.
A butterfly. A wolf's head. two faces back to back. A shadow. A threatening shadow.
I have the results of your MRI scans. Everything seems to be normal. There is no physical damage from the accident. However, I am worried about your psychological condition. I know it's not easy, but you've got to start over, Ethan. You're not responsible for what happened.
It's my fault Jason is dead. He'd still be alive if I'd been looking out for him.
It was an accident. Accidents happen every day. You can't blame yourself forever for your son's death. How is Sean?
I know he's really unhappy. He just can't understand why I seem unable to love him.
And what about you, Ethan? What do you feel?
I stopped living at the same time Jason did. When that car ran into us.
Is there something else you wanted to tell me, Ethan?
No. No.
That's the end of this session. We'll continue this conversation next week. You were lucky, Ethan. It's very rare to survive such a traumatic accident.
I don't exactly feel lucky, Doctor.